Okay, in this section we will learn what is local stack and how to use it for testing AWS cloud applications on local machine. For the agenda, first we will see what is local stack and what are the features of local stack. Then the precondition or tools required to finish the sample application we will be using for the demo. After that, we will analyze the sample application workflow. And at last, we will see the sample application running in AWS cloud and then mimic the behavior in our local machine using local stack. So local stack is a mock framework, currently only supports AWS, that create a testing environment on your local machine, and you can use the AWS CLI to communicate with the mock environment. Using local stack, you can test your application on your local machine first, and when you all set, then take your code and infra to real AWS environment. That also saves time to test small changes and fixes, as you don't have to upload your code on cloud frequently, and that save overall cost of your testing environment. These are some preconditions before you start using local stack to try the application workflow. First is Python runtime. Then the AWS CLI to communicate with local stack cloud environment. Next is Docker or Docker desktop for Windows operating system to start local stack server using Docker image. And any IDE of your choice. And it's good to have AWS plugin installed that will help you creating Lambda function in no time. This is our sample application workflow that we will be used for local stack demo. We are going to use three components of AWS, that is S3 bucket, DynamoDB and Lambda function. We will create S3 bucket, create a DynamoDB table and Lambda function, and then attach a trigger to Lambda function on create object event for S3 bucket. So when we put a JSON file into S3 bucket whose schema is similar to the DynamoDB table schema, Lambda function will trigger that read the JSON file and put the content into DynamoDB table. Let's see all of this in action. Before starting the local stack demo, we will first see the sample application workflow in actual AWS environment. So we have created the S3 bucket named person bucket that contains uber jar of our Lambda function we have deployed. Then we have DynamoDB table name person detail that is empty, and Lambda function in which we deployed the uber jar code we just saw, and also attach a trigger to listen to person buckets create object event. Now let's upload the JSON data file into S3 bucket and see our Lambda function working. File is uploaded successfully. Now go to DynamoDB table and refresh. Okay. As you can see that Lambda function populate the data into table. Now let me walk you through the code first. So this is a Lambda function created using AWS SDK that listen to S3 events. Any environment variable passed, we can fetch it from system ENVs. Then create an object of Amazon S3 so that when we upload a file to S3 bucket, it read the content of the file. This is the code that we use to connect to local stack S3 service. We are fetching the local stack hostname environment variable exposed by local stack and use it for the endpoint configuration of S3 service. The reason provided is default for local stack. And the same configuration required for Amazon DynamoDB. There is one more Java class that is %detail, which is just the mapping of DynamoDB table. There is another file that we will use to add a trigger to Lambda function, which is notification.json, that contains the ARN of our Lambda function. Without further delay, let's start the localstack server using the Docker command. Running localstack using Docker is the recommended way, and if you are running it for the first time, it will download the image from Docker registry and the image size is around 500 megabytes. LocalStack is now starting the AWS mock services in local machine on specified ports. Let's wait for all the services to be running. Okay, LocalStack server is ready. We are going to use DynamoDB, which is running on port 4569, S3 bucket running on port 4572, and Lambda service running on port 4574. Now we start creating the AWS component one by one. First, create S3 bucket using this command. The endpoint flag is important here, which is pointing to localstack server, and the rest of the command is same for a real AWS environment. Now DynamoDB table with table name as %detail, attribute name as ID of type number. The endpoint details of localstack DynamoDB service. All the details we specified is available in Java mapping class %detail view. Table created. And then the Lambda function with name sample lambda, runtime as Java 8, the handler function, which is the combination of package and class name of our Lambda function code, the location of Lambda function Uber jar, and role parameter is mandatory, but you can put anything as value. Now copy this Lambda function ARN and paste it in the notification JSON. Now let's create a S3 put bucket notification on person bucket and provide notification JSON file as configuration for that. Let's scan the DynamoDB table first, and the item count is 0. Now we put the sample JSON file in S3 bucket. File uploaded successfully. Scan the DynamoDB again. Lambda is not yet triggered. Let's try again. Okay, so Lambda function invoked and all the entries present in sample JSON file are populated in DynamoDB table. Again, local stack hostname is the important modification that need to be done when connecting with local stack server. We used inline docker command to run local stack, but you can also use docker compose file provided at local stack GitHub page. You can find the location of code AWS command used and related files in the video description. And with this, we conclude our chapter. Thank you for watching. You may now move on.